Guys. First and foremost, welcome to another Triple the Shenanigans vlog. If you're new here, don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, all that good stuff. As you can probably hear, I sound a little weird because sicknesses run in our house non-stop. Why? Because our kids go to daycare and kids are germy and gross. And with it being the summer now, they have a bunch of new people and they have a bunch of new kids. And then Kylie also works there. And so our kids are always sick, which means we're always sick. And here we are with another cold of some kind. Yeah, there's a lot that I need to tell you guys about. And mostly today we're talking about one big event that kind of turned our lives upside down for about 24 hours. So let's get into that. Let's do it. You know how much we love to talk about the fact that it is like a billion degrees here in Arizona. And this summer, it seems like the heat just got to us way quicker. And the reason we talk about the heat so much is because it literally hinders us from being able to do anything. We can't really go outside without dehydrating or getting a really bad sunburn or just feeling terrible. Like, you just can feel the heat, and it's all day and even all night. Like, it could be 9 p.m. and it's still in the triple digits. So let me try and explain this to the best of my ability on like the timeline, okay? Let's just go from like a Monday through a Sunday here. The dates are not really relevant, so I'm just gonna go through the week. So let's just say that on Monday, we noticed that like our guest bathroom was warmer than usual. And we were like, ugh, it's stuffy in here. Like, it feels like there needs to be some ventilation. And we keep the door closed because the kids like to go in there. So we thought, okay, maybe it's because the door's been closed, whatever. So we just tried to leave the doors open and thought it was us, right? And we went and checked our air filters, make sure all our air filters were good for the air conditioning, and making sure we're touching on all the points that would make our air conditioning suck, basically. And now during this week, the highs were at like 109, 108 here where we live, and a little bit further in town, which is where the daycare is, was like at 111. And we knew it was gonna be hot, so we were just like, you know, it is what it is, it's gonna be warmer. We haven't seen this kind of weather in a while, so it's gonna take some time for everything to kind of catch up. So fast forward, let's go, let's say Tuesday now. And we didn't really notice any big significant differences. It's just kind of warmer. Wednesday, we started to like feel like it felt stuffier and it felt warmer. And when we looked at the thermostat, it looked warmer, but we thought maybe our settings were off because we had been messing with some of the schedules. And to be honest, I don't know what half of the language on the thermostat actually is. So we just were kind of trying to figure it out. Thursday comes along and everyone's at like work or school. I'm here, and around 11 a.m., maybe noon, I look at the thermostat and it says it's like 79 in here. And we like to keep it at 75, 76 sometimes. So I'm like, 79, like the air should have kicked down by now. Like, that's weird, but it is the middle of the day. Maybe it's just really hot, and it was probably one of the warmest days that we had had. So I was like, I'll give it some time. And a little bit later, I started to feel even warmer. And I was like, what the heck? Looked at the thermostat, it was at like 80. It climbed all the way to about 81, 82 by the time like 4 o'clock came around. And I had to leave to go pick up the kids. So I was like, well, shoot, you know, it's getting warm. I mean, hopefully as the sun goes down, the air kind of like, I don't know, works better. And so I left. I was like, if I come back and it's still at 80, like we're gonna have to figure something out. And it's the first time I'd ever experienced that in any of the houses that we've had. So whatever, I left, came back with the kids, and it had dropped to about 77. So I was like, okay, it's working. It's just, maybe it's too hot for the air conditioning. I don't know. Like, maybe it's just the way that the sun hits the AC unit, or the way that the sun hits our windows. Our house is energy efficient, so that shouldn't be a problem, but I was just trying to like justify it. And so I had told Candace about it, and we were just kind of talking it through. We went through the thermostat, everything looked good. That Thursday night, we finally got back to like 75 or 74 degrees at like 10 o'clock at night, if not a little bit later, but we were able to sleep comfortably. And then Friday came around and Candace was working from home. I said, you know, let's keep all the curtains closed. Let's keep the blinds, the curtains, everything. Let's just close it. Let's keep it dark in here. Maybe we'll preserve some of the cold air and things will be better. So we did that. And even in the room, Candace was working in there. We took off Mr.'s doggy door because we know that this isn't sealed. And because we take it on and off so much, this was something that we took off on like Wednesday, if not sooner, because we wanted to make sure that this wasn't the reason why it was so hot. And when you would touch the windows, like they didn't feel warm. We also have double pane, so I'm like, I don't think it's coming through the windows, but you know, we'll see. So that Friday, this is where it gets interesting, okay? It's Friday now, end of the week, Candace is sick. I'm starting to get sick. Kids are tired. Kylie has worked all week, but she's actually going to her dad's because it's Father's Day weekend and she was gonna be with her dad. So, 11 o'clock comes around and it's already at like 78 degrees in here. And we were like, dang, it's climbing a little bit quicker. And then noon and then 1 p.m. and it's like 80 degrees in here already. And we can feel it, like it is significantly warmer in here. And 2 o'clock and it's warm. So I remembered, excuse me, that my mother-in-law had let us borrow a little AC unit that we used to use in the garage, but it's one that has a hose that you have to take out so that it kind of, I don't know how to explain it, but I brought it in here because I was like, you know, we're desperate at this point, and if we go down this route, it's gonna end up being like 90 degrees before it's time to go get the kids, and who knows what's gonna happen after that, if it's gonna cool down. I mean, based on what happened on Thursday, that would be the assumption that is that it would cool down. And when we would touch up on the vents, you can feel the air coming in, and it was cold, but it wasn't a lot of air. So we put the little AC unit here. It started to cool this area down, but the temperature would not go under 82 degrees. That's kind of where we stayed. For a little bit, it went up to 83, but then it would drop to 82. Back to 83, and then back to 82. So I think the little AC unit was helping, but it wasn't really making that big of a difference. It was probably just keeping the house from getting even warmer. And upstairs was even hotter because, you know, heat rises, I think. It's hot, like it's really hot. And I told Candace, like, we need to have like a plan, because if it doesn't cool down, I guess let's give ourselves a time frame, like a time limit. If it doesn't cool down by a certain time, we're gonna have to decide if we stay here and kind of maybe use the little AC unit to cool off one bedroom and we all sleep in there and hope that that thing lasts all night, or we have to leave. I said, because there's no way the kids could sleep in this kind of weather, and it's gonna get even hotter throughout the night. That means they would be sleeping in 90 plus degrees, which is not good. And so, you know, we were trying to debate, do we try and find a hotel? We have Mister, the dog. We can't just go anywhere. We have to pack all their pack and plays and all their things that they would need for the night. And this isn't something that like we've ever really done. I mean, our house is only 2 years old, so this would be the last thing that I was expecting to deal with. So I said, let me go get the kids. When we come back, if nothing has changed, we're gonna have to figure something out. And so sure enough, I went, grabbed the kids. By the time I got home, it was about 5:30, and it was 83, 82, no different. And when we touched the air in the vents, it was no longer cold air, it was hot. Not hot air, but it was not, like it was just air. And we really started to stress out because we're like, man, like this is real, we have to go somewhere. And we're very lucky we have both of our parents here. I also have a sister that lives here, but we're an entourage. We're not just a couple people crashing in a place, you know? And my mom has dogs that are really loud and bark a lot. My family is really loud. Candace's parents have like 3 dogs that are all really loud. Like, you can't even make noise or they start to bark like crazy. So we were thinking, like, we can't take the kids there because they're not gonna sleep. All they're gonna hear is dog barking and people, and we're gonna have a really rough night that way. And so we were like, you know, we're gonna have to go to a hotel. We can't really afford a hotel, but we're gonna have to figure it out because we can't stay here. So at this point, we have no other option. So by this, it's 6:30. The kids go to sleep in about half an hour, and they had just finished eating dinner, but they were all wild and all over the place running around. Meanwhile, Candace and I are trying to pack their clothes, their beds, their blankets, the shushers that they have in their room, our clothes, Mr. Stuff, and oh my god, it was so overwhelming. And to add to that, Candace had received some really sad news from a family member, and on top of not feeling great, I think she just reached her tipping point and she just broke down. And we're still in the middle of the crisis. We're still at home. We're still trying to figure everything out. And I told her, babe, we gotta get it together. Like, I love you and we're gonna get through this. It's a rough day and we're, you know, but we're gonna get through it. And someday in the future, we might laugh about this. Not today, definitely not today. So we packed what we could. We looked online and booked whatever hotel we could find that had a separate living room to bedroom, because we also hadn't eaten, Candace and I hadn't eaten dinner, and we wanted to make sure that we could leave to go grab food or something. Meanwhile, the kids needed to go down to sleep like soon because they were already past their bedtime and they were cranky because it was Friday and they had a long week. And so we booked whatever hotel we could. Luckily, a friend of ours was like a lifesaver and was able to take Mr. in for the night. So we ended up not having to take Mr. to the hotel, which was really helpful, because I don't know how that would have gone. So we dropped him off on the way to the hotel. We got to the hotel, the kids walked in, like explored everything in the hotel because they were curious while we set up their bed. We had already gotten them in their jammies, so we just needed to change diapers and put them down. And they struggled to fall asleep because it's a new place and everything just kind of happened so fast. But we put them in their bed and they thankfully fell asleep and thankfully slept well. They didn't like freak out. All things considered, they slept good. I'll have to tell you guys a story of the hotel itself, probably in another vlog. I don't want to ramble on too much on this one, but I wanted to give you all a heads up and just update you all on what has happened. I'm sorry, it's just me talking, but it was a rough one. We didn't sleep great. Candace and I did not sleep great. I think we were just so worried. To actually wrap up this whole AC thing, on Thursday I had called to get somebody out there like as soon as possible, and the soonest they kept telling me they could come was Monday. And I was like, no, there's no way we can wait till Monday. We have kids, you know, we have to be in our house. We have a dog. And I called like 8 different companies, and of those 8, 1 agreed to come out on Saturday. Well, while we were going through this whole hotel thing, we were talking to Kylie. Candace was texting with her, and Kylie happened to mention something to her dad. And her dad has owned properties in the past, so he has a lot of like these people on like call and just people that he's built relationships with. And I guess he reached out to one of his AC guys and said, hey, you know, can you do me a favor? And he ended up helping us get somebody out for Saturday morning. So we stayed at the hotel Friday night. Saturday morning we woke up and we came home. The guy ended up coming about 9 o'clock, 9:30, and within 15 minutes he had fixed the problem. Something with a capacitor in our AC was broken, so they had to replace it. And it's been working great since. But all things considered, it was, after the hecticness and the overwhelmingness, it was like pretty smooth sailing as far as the fix and the AC goes, and we were able to stay in our house. And now we're just so grateful and happy to be here, and it just makes you appreciate just your living circumstances so much more, because, you know, we were thrown a curveball and it was tough, but we got through it and here we are. And Candace is feeling a lot better. I sound worse than I feel. I feel okay. It's just my voice sounds funny and I have kind of congestion. The kids are better. They're good. Kylie came home yesterday and She felt bad she wasn't around to help us, but we told her it was probably better that she was over with her dad, because trying to like make sure that another one of our kids was good and comfortable and all that, I think would have just been more stressful. So knowing that she was comfortable and taken care of at her dad's was helpful. So we are all better. Things are better, and hopefully we can vlog today or tomorrow with the kids so that you guys can see them. They are growing every day, and they are just characters. So with that said, I will wrap up this video here. If you have any questions, or if I left out any parts of the story, or if there are any gaps, I'm sorry. I was trying to like think through the whole thing, and we can answer more later. We can always come back to this stuff. So thank you guys so much for watching. We love you. We will see you on the next one. Bye.